By all common measures of movie quality, Mission Impossible number 4, Ghost Protocol, is a good movie. It was big at the box office when it came out, and the critics still love it. It's over 90% fresh at RottenTomatoes.com. Good movies often feature good acting, but I'm amazed how often good movies feature bad action. Action scenes that defy the laws of physics, and perhaps the laws of probability. These scenes not only hurt our aesthetic sensibilities, they just look wrong and can mar our enjoyment of a movie, but they also hurt our physical intuition, making us a little dumber about the way the world really works. Someone who has seen enough bad action scenes begins to believe that you really might be able to, say, dodge a bullet, or that you really can jump to safety from a high-speed car. Let's take a look at such a scene from Ghost Protocol. Here, Tom Cruise is racing after a bad guy during a sandstorm in Dubai. Tom, in his blue car, is about to have a head-on collision with the bad guy, whose car is symbolized in red on Tom's handheld GPS receiver. Watch what happens. Wow. The acrobatic car seems unlikely, but that's much more likely than what has happened to Tom after he jumps from the car onto the caressing, soft fingers of Dubai asphalt. Just before the collision, the speedometer in Tom's car indicates a speed slightly greater than 90 kilometers per hour. In American units, that's 56 miles per hour. When Tom bails out of the car, his body, is also going 56 miles per hour. And when he soon hits the pavement, he is still going 56 miles per hour. Maybe air resistance has slowed him down to a more legal 55, but he's still going to hit the asphalt at ordinary urban freeway speeds. I asked trauma surgeon Dr. Rochelle Dicker, associate professor of surgery at the University of California, someone who's seen a lot of auto accident victims, what happens to people who jump or are thrown out of cars at freeway speeds? Professor Dicker said such people are, and I quote, likely to have life-threatening injuries, unquote. Life-threatening injuries. But what happens to Tom Cruise in Mission Impossible Ghost Protocol? Tom has a limp and a 2-inch tear in his trousers. Maybe Tom was lucky. Don't some people who bail out of a car at freeway speeds get lucky? We expect our movie heroes to be lucky. Yes, but when our heroes are fantastically lucky, in scene after scene, the movie itself becomes fantastic. It becomes a fantasy. Fantasy movies are fine, of course, but when patently unrealistic action happens in real-world, not fantasy-world, settings, our intelligence is insulted, and our physical intuition is assaulted. We all get a little dumber about the way the world really works.